Welcome to MATLAB. Today, you're on your journey to discover plotting of horizontal and vertical lines on a graph paper. Before we get on with plotting of lines, there are a few terms you need to remember. The Cartesian coordinates give the position of a point in two-dimensional space by stating its shortest distance from two fixed reference lines set at right angles to each other. The distances may be given as positive or negative values. The axes are the two fixed lines in the Cartesian coordinate system. They are usually identified separately as the x-axis and the y-axis. Look at this picture. The x-axis and y-axis have been plotted for you. Are the two axes set at right angles to each other? An ordered pair is the two numbers written in a particular order needed to give the position of a point in the Cartesian coordinate system. The convention is to give the x-coordinate or the axis are first and the y-coordinate or the ordinate second. The x-coordinate of a point in Cartesian coordinates is its distance from the y-axis. The y-coordinate of a point in Cartesian coordinates is its distance from the x-axis. The origin in the Cartesian coordinate system is the point where the two axes cross. So let me mark the origin for you. It is the point identified as O and given by the ordered pair 0, 0. How do we plot the point P 2, 3? The x coordinate of P is 2, that is, P moves 2 units from the y-axis. The y-coordinate of the point is 3, that is, P has moved 3 units from the x-axis. So right here we have the point P, 2, 3. Look at the points in the given figure. The point A has moved 4 units to the right of the y-axis, or the distance from the y-axis is 4. And it remains on the x-axis, that is, its distance from the x-axis is 0. Can you identify the coordinates of A? Yes, indeed, A has coordinates 4, 0. Can you identify the coordinates of B? B has moved 2 units to the left of the y-axis and it has remained on the x-axis. So, its coordinates are minus 2, 0. What do you observe? Any point on the x-axis has its y-coordinate as 0. Therefore, the equation of the x-axis is y is equal to 0. Can you plot the lines y equal to 1 and y equal to minus 2? On this graph paper, we know the equation of the x-axis is y equal to 0. Therefore, y is equal to 1 is a line parallel to the x-axis. Any point on this line is 1 unit above the x-axis. Y equal to minus 2 is a line parallel to the x-axis. Any point on this line is 2 units below the x-axis. Look at these points in the given figure. The point C has not moved from the y-axis, but it has moved 3 units above the x-axis. Therefore, its coordinates is 0, 3. Similarly, the coordinates of the point D is 0, minus 4. What do you observe? Any point on the y-axis, its x-coordinate is 0. Therefore, the equation of the y-axis is x is equal to 0. Can you plot the lines? X is equal to minus 2 and x equal to 4 on this graph sheet. X is equal to minus 2 is parallel to the y-axis. Any point on x is equal to minus 2 is 2 units to the left of the y-axis. X is equal to 4 is a line parallel to the y-axis. Any point on x is equal to 4 is at a distance of 4 units to the right of the y-axis. Look carefully at this picture. We can conclude that any equation of the form y equal to constant is parallel to the x-axis. Any equation of the form x is equal to constant is parallel to the y-axis. Today, you're provided with a lab observation sheet, a graph sheet, and cutouts of lines whose equations are of the form x equal to constant or y equal to constant. Identify the points on your graph sheet and note your observations. Can you find the equation of the x-axis and the y-axis? Using your cutouts, paste the lines in your graph paper and note your observations. When two lines intersect, they meet at a point. Can you find the point P where x is equal to 4 and y equal to minus 1 meet? Remember, we need to note the x coordinate first and then the y coordinate. Have fun graphing vertical and horizontal lines.